Oral squamous cell carcinoma, very simply put, is a malignant neoplasm of the squamous cell or keratinocyte. Various factors induce DNA mutations in the squamous cell, causing excess proliferation of these cells, leading to cancer. Oral squamous cell carcinoma is known to be the most common oral malignancy and is reported to account for 90% of all cancers occurring in the oral cavity. Very often, squamous cell carcinoma is preceded by oral potentially malignant disorders like leukoplakia or erythroplakia. Oral squamous cell carcinoma is known to have a multifactorial etiology. Both tobacco smoking and smokeless tobacco are regarded to be strongly linked to cause oral squamous cell carcinoma. In fact, majority of individuals with squamous cell carcinoma are known to have a smoking habit. Pipe and cigar smoking are reported to be riskier than cigarette smoking when it comes to causing oral squamous cell carcinoma. Pipe smokers have a strong predilection for squamous cell carcinoma of the lower lip. Bidi smoking, prevalent in places like India, is known to be 3 times riskier than cigarette smoking. A deleterious habit called reverse smoking, where the smoker keeps a lighted end of the cigarette inside the mouth, is known to have the highest risk of causing oral squamous cell carcinoma. In these cases, it is the hard palate that is usually affected. Other habits like chewing dry or wet snuff and tobacco pouching are also known to cause oral squamous cell carcinoma. Tobacco smoking or chewing is the most common etiologic factor in causing squamous cell carcinoma in places like India. Most commonly, tobacco habits lead to causing oral potentially malignant disorders like leukoplakia, erythroplakia, leukoerythroplakia, and submucous fibrosis. Now, though not all of them transform, they have the potential to become malignant. Most cases of oral squamous cell carcinoma are preceded by dysplastic, potentially malignant disorders. Though alcohol does not have a direct correlation, it is reported to work in synergy with tobacco in causing oral squamous cell carcinoma. Alcohol in combination with tobacco is a considerable risk factor. Betel quid consists of a betel leaf that wraps a mixture of areca nut, slicket lime, tobacco, and other spices. Betel quid chewing is mainly implicated in causing oral submucous fibrosis. Moreover, oral submucous fibrosis is classified as a potentially malignant disorder and is estimated to have 7 to 13% rate of malignant transformation. High fat and sugar intake with low fruits and vegetables has been implicated to be a risk factor. Low levels of vitamin A and C is another risk factor. Plummer-Vinson syndrome, also called Patterson-Kelly syndrome, is one of the most significant manifestations of iron deficiency anemia. It predisposes an individual to pharyngeal or esophageal squamous cell carcinoma. Patients with a compromised immune system have considerable risk in developing oral squamous cell carcinoma, especially individuals with diseases like HIV or AIDS. Patients whose immune system are suppressed for bone marrow or organ transplant have been reported to develop oral cancer. A number of studies have reported human papillomavirus to be associated with oropharyngeal carcinomas. Certain strains of Candida albicans are known to produce N-nitrosobenzyl methylamine, which is a carcinogen. It has been reported that these products, either directly or in association with other carcinogens, could induce oral squamous cell carcinoma. A clinical type of candidal lesion called hyperplastic candidiasis is known to manifest with dysplasia histologically. Now, there are reports that state candida organisms could induce hyperplasia and cause hyperkeratotic white lesions. Hence, some pathologists and investigators believe hyperplastic candidiasis could cause dysplastic leukoplakic lesions and regard them as being potentially malignant. However, there are researchers who doubt this condition could arise as a result of Candida and believe it to be a candidal infection superimposed on a pre-existing leukoplakic lesion. The above-listed etiologic factors or mutagens, especially tobacco and betel quid, could cause genetic alterations or mutations of the squamous cell that alter their biologic behavior. Accumulated or induced mutations help the damaged cells to persist, that is, escape apoptosis and proliferate. At this stage, mutated squamous cells are tumor cells and are histologically atypical. Usually, there is a healthy balance of cell proliferation induced by oncogenes and cell cycle arrest by tumor suppressor genes. Mutations accumulating in oncogenes and tumor suppressor genes result in altered cell behavior and carcinogenesis. Oncogenes are proteins that help cells proliferate. Mutations in oncogenes could cause uncontrolled proliferation of cells. And tumor suppressor genes are proteins that help arrest the cell cycle and also cause apoptosis of the cell when necessary. Mutations in tumor suppressor genes, usually P16, P53, and P21, could cause uncontrolled proliferation of cells, since mutations cause the tumor suppressor genes from functioning properly, thus indirectly helping proliferation.